And I will transition to the next slide. Okay, so let me get into intro to big data. I think most of us might have heard what is big data, but just to give completeness, most of us relate big data to volume, variety, and velocity. So volume is a lot of data that is in terabytes and petabytes of data, and variety is, I mean, we want to put everything which contains no format or various format into one table or one data source or one source where you can start analyzing the entire data. Okay, and velocity is the speed in which these data or these information is coming into the system. We need to handle the speed. So with all these three things, right, I mean, we call the technologies that handle these three V's is what we call as big data. Okay, and most of our clients at this point of time, right, are using it to do analytics, big data analytics, and some of them are also doing to replace their entire what to call the old data warehousing systems and all those things. We will look into it further into the presentation, but I wanted to show you this in the left hand side portion, right? I mean, what constitutes big data? I mean, from the various industry. This is a slide, or this is the information that I have taken it from McKinsey Global Institute. They have done a survey of big data, and they have understood, or they have come out with a report that many of these industries like banking, insurance, all of them have a large penetration of unstructured data. I mean, that is what this heat map is showing here. Okay, and what is happening is most of these unstructured data is not mined today to serve their customers. Okay, so that is their finding, and this report is around 2011-12 kind time frame. Okay, and if you look at this right hand corner, 1 minute, let me just move this part. Yeah, right hand corner, you see that the most of this big data being used by the information companies like Google's and Yahoo's and all those things. And if you also look at the little observe little closely, the middle part of it, right, I mean, the healthcare services, the financial services, and the insurance are the big candidates that are likely to adopt big data technologies for various reasons. I mean, because they have a lot of legacy systems, there are a lot of data, and they are into the business of optimizing things post this 2008 what to call downturn. Okay, so what we see in the industry is leave alone this Google's, Facebook's, and those kind of industries, I mean, at least from the enterprise companies like let's say Apple or BofA, Bank of America, or any other companies like ICICI Bank or any other companies, right, I mean, those are also adopting big data. And I will also talk about how they are adopting big data, but let me transition to the next slide. Okay, so what we see as we speak to multiple clients, at least we are working with 50-60 clients, and we see that 80% of their data is unstructured data. Okay, and only 20% of which is being used for their analytical purpose and real-time dashboarding and all those things. So if you look at it, right, majority of data is untapped, and they do not know what is happening in this unstructured data. I mean, I will just give you a simple example. For example, let's say I and the company X get into a contract, and I am always saying that, okay, if I have a milestone at some point of time, let's say after 2 months, and if I have to deliver some amount of work, right, I mean, there is no way that the contract document can be correlated with my output. So these are the problems that are really industry is facing. For example, this is one of the problems that mining guys are facing. For example, right, I mean, if I get into a contract and if my output has to be so-and-so tons of, let's say, bauxite, I mean, there is no way to measure against a contract unless a manual guy comes and measures it. So today that is a challenge that we are having in the this one, unstructured data. So this big data technologies gives us a hope to mine these kind of unstructured data, blend it with the structured data, and try to provide real-time analytics. Okay, so let me transition to the next slide. Okay, so this is a nice visual that I have put together. You can see that. I mean, this one, right? I mean, the left-hand side, I'm showing a very structured information that is contributing to the analytics. Okay, and these are the reactive type of analytics, what people would have done. Okay, what has gone wrong in my system, or who is performing well, what is doing well, those kind of things, right? And this, the middle part is what I am showing as a little bit of unstructuredness is there. I mean, that is for purpose. I mean, if you look at it, right, my data is, I do not know what the data is, but it is large unstructured data, very complex data, but I want to bring it into my mainstream analytics and provide value for this. Okay, so these new things, right? I mean, these things need a different mindset, and that is what this machine learning techniques help us to do. And there is a new breed of people that are coming up called data scientists. We will talk about it a little later, but this is the state in which the analytical practice is evolving right now. So there is a backroom analytics that is going on. There is a real-time analytics that that we wanted to do, and most of the information is hidden in the unstructured part of the unstructured data. Okay. So the evolution is we want to embed this unstructuredness and the traditional structured data into the analytical process, provide insights which are meaningful, and they can action take action or institutionalize that this one. Okay, so that is what we are trying to, that is what we are seeing in most of our clients. Okay, let me go to the next slide. Okay, so if you look at it, right, I mean, people can ask, hey, this analytic practice has been there for a while, I mean, for almost centuries together, but what is so different? I mean, we have started optimizing the math behind the analytics, and today's problem, or what we call as long tail problems, in the sense that we are trying to find needle in a haystack sometimes. I mean, the population is very large, and sometimes what happens is that the probability of making a sampling error is very high, and you might lose out the real meaning by doing that sampling. These kind of technologies, right, this big data technologies, allows you to take a large set of data and go and do a deep dive analytics into it. Okay, so one example that I'm showing here is, one example that I'm showing here is how the risk of underwriting goes with the various inclusion of various set of data. Okay, so if I start including various diverse information, my risk of underwriting my insurance goes down. So I am just giving you an example, and this is what we have shown it to one of our insurance clients. So more and more you start incorporating various data, you can try to reduce the risk in your business. Okay, so I wanted to just take a minute or two to compare the traditional analytics versus the new approach that we see that the industry is going towards. Okay, so in the old people come back and say that we need a business domain guy who comes back and says that, hey, can you find out what is going on, can you tell me what has happened in the last 3 months, those kind of analysis is what normally happens. And what people normally do is they go and get data from various sources, they have a what to call somehow they need to integrate the data, and data integration has got various problems like schema matching. We do not know which column to match where, how to make a unique record. Those problems are still there, and they use these technologies like SAS, IBM, SPSS, and all those things, and they try to make hypothesis, and they test the hypothesis, and they go back and tell that, hey, whatever you have thought through is correct or wrong. Whereas in today's world, right, I mean, we have technologies to tell business domain guys, say that this seems to be happening, can you go and check in your business and find out, I can also go and help them and say that why this is happening. So the trend is changing towards more proactive than reactive. And the technologies, it is not just a couple of variables, we are talking about more than tens and tens of variables that affect the business. Okay, so that is the shift that we are seeing in the analytical side. Okay, so this machine learning techniques is helping us to get to that scale and try to do predictive analytics. For example, right, we are discussing with a couple of customers where we want to tell them that a particular part of a mission can fail at this point of time and it might need a service. Okay, so those are the kind of things that we are doing. That is where the industry is moving towards. Okay, and let me just go to the next slide. It is transitioning right now. Yeah, it is almost there. Let me see. Okay, so the OLTP system, right? How is it changing with big data? So in the olden days, or in even in many systems even today, right, people work out of RDBMS and they work out of various other technologies like Java, J2EE, all those things. And I'm not saying it is bad, but the problem is there is a limit to many of these things. If you want to really benefit out of this unstructured data and all those things, right, it is not possible for Oracle database an RDBMS kind of a database to have unstructuredness or to have to accommodate the various formats in the data. We have to make schema changes very often and all those things. So there is a new breed of technology that is coming up, which is a NoSQL kind of technologies where you can dump in any kind of format, and these are the databases have, the underlying technology that is underpinning these databases are distributed database techniques. Okay, so what happens is you can scale the system or the scale the database as we increase, as we go with the load. And there are a lot of concepts very similar to RDBMS like sharding, replication, all those things. But those are all abstracted by the product nowadays and you don't need to do anything with this. And the DBA activities are also coming down. So if you look at it, right, the OLTP system, many of the systems that I have seen or many of that we are seeing is it can scale up to a point of time and beyond which your traditional systems are not able to scale, either because of you are not able to increase your cluster size or your database is your single point of choking point. So there are technologies which these big data technologies like NoSQL kind of databases like MongoDB or Cassandra or MarkLogic kind of databases, right? They give you distribution of their data in Oracle world, or in, we call it as partitioning, but that is much more sleeker here and they call it auto sharding here. And coming to the next part, right, the compute power, if I want to do a very complex calculation, in olden days people used to do it in one machine, one VM. Now we have techniques to do it across multiple machines. That is what we call as high performance computing. And Hadoop is one of them. Hadoop can be used one of them. Okay, so in nutshell, what we are seeing is most of these technologies are converging towards distributed systems, whether it is big data or NoSQL or whatever it is, right? The systems are getting converted to distributed systems, and many of these constructs like fault tolerance, replication, various distributed concepts have been already abstracted within these frameworks. Okay. So that is the crux of this particular slide that I wanted to talk about. Okay, let me transition to the next slide. So in effect, right, what we are seeing with the